all, welcome to our youth concert this evening. The Lord bless you. Thank you very much for coming. We're going to begin our concert by singing together, O Come, O Ye Faithful. And we'll take two verses, first one seated, and then we'll take the last verse standing, after which we shall be led in congregational prayer, and Rhoda Akaka will pray for us.
This time that we can remember, this Christmas time that we can remember how much you've done for us, Jesus. And we just want to praise your name, Father Lord. We just accept our thanks and praises, Jesus. And I just pray for the choir and the orchestra and everything that we do tonight, Jesus, that we'll just give all the praise to you. And Lord Jesus, I just pray that we are all changed by anything that happens here tonight, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you.
Oh, the everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
So far? Oh, wow. Okay, I think we need to go home then. They're not enjoying themselves. Are you actually enjoying yourself so far? Yes. Praise God. Our next session is a congregational song, but just before we take that song, the orchestra choir are going to move around into the orchestra seating position. But as youth, we've had many activities throughout the year, and we've always had opportunities to host different events, and there are also so many, as we call them, unsung heroes, people who do a lot of work in the background. For example, the program that you have next to you, with you, the image was designed by one of the young people in the church who, and just want to show appreciation, we had so many of them throughout the year who have done different events for us. So we had Bori Arimu. Did our January event. We also have Ayo Olaisade. She did our youth camp. We also have
use the mic.
See, I'm getting old. I've forgotten his name. Philip Undoyo. He also has been very helpful. I've just woken him up. And also we have Jonathan Irenra, who actually did the poster for us. Please, just give them a round of applause if they can stand up. Stand up. Come on. Ayo. Okay. Yes, we have a small token for you, so we'll give it to you after the program. Thank you very much for your help, and we're looking forward to 2018. So we're going to sing Away in the Manger now, and we're going to ask Anu to come up and conduct. Just take one verse, make them stand. One verse, make them stand up.
So before we sing Away in a Manger, we've got one more tribute. She doesn't know that it's to her. Well, we've got a tribute to our youth leader, Sister Ollis. So if you could give Sister Ollis a round of applause. So this is just a token of appreciation from the youth body, from all of us. We've chipped in, we've talked about this. And this is just to show appreciation, that we really appreciate you being our youth leader, all of your hard work. We've got a little video that's going to be sent to you, just us. You know, it's going to be sent to you, don't worry, you're not going to see it. But yeah, we just really appreciate you, and we hope you enjoy your gift. So now we're going to sing Away in a Manger. We're going to sing one verse, I'm going to stand up.
Thank you. the Savior was born on Christmas Day, to save us all from Satan's power when we have gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
Joy.
Bum, 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 bum
your baby boy would one day walk on water. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you deliver will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby
choristers. They've really thrilled our hearts, and God wants to thrill our hearts too, because it's that time of the year where everyone is happy, where everyone is rejoicing. We can feel the joy in the air. May God bless us. Today we want to encourage ourselves, because it is the night before the dawn of Christmas, the eve of Christmas, as we commemorate that time where Christ came for us. We want to consider some words, and I want to choose a word from one of my role models, and he has influenced a whole lot of people around the globe. I'm talking about Paul the Apostle. You know, he preached the Christmas message to some group of people who misunderstood the whole concept of Christmas. So today, we want to actually look at the objective of Christmas. There is an objective to everything. Many have said Christ is the reason for Christmas. But there is a reason why Christ is the reason for Christmas. And that's why we want to turn our Bible to Galatians chapter 4. Galatians chapter 4. I'll begin the reading from verse 4. But when the fullness of time was come, God sent forth his son, made of a woman, made under the law, to redeem them that were under the law, that he might receive the adoption of sons. And because ye are sons, God has sent forth the Holy Spirit of his Son unto your hearts, crying, Abba, Father. That's the message of Christmas. I think the people of Galatians at this time misunderstood the whole concept of Christmas. And they thought it is only for a time. And if you read down the scripture, you see that there was a time. They said, I'll just go there. It says, a time that They consider seasons. They consider years and say, maybe it is only this time of Jubilee that God can redeem. No, God can redeem all the time. Yes. And that's the objective of Christmas, is to redeem you, is to redeem me from that bondage which Satan has put man, and to bring us into a relationship whereby we can cry, Abba, Father. Amen. And when we cry, like every child, my children asked me, what have you for me for Christmas? I had to struggle, and indeed I was thinking, what gift will I give them? And so I did something, and they said they needed it under the Christmas tree. You know, we may be carried away by all those things, the celebration, the getting together, and forget the purpose of Christmas. That purpose is to redeem. I love that song, O come, Emmanuel. Yes. You know, it's a prayer. Yes. And when we sing it from our hearts, do you know the Lord will surely come? Amen. And when he comes, he's going to redeem us. From the bondage of Satan, and he will save us for his people. Tonight can be that night where we'll have a silent night, where you can have that quiet time to yourself to reflect, what has Christ come to do for me? You know, the prophet Isaiah prophesied and said, for unto us a son, a child is born. Unto us a son is given. You see, a son is given, but he came in form of a child. Because God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Just before the child, God has pre-planned this thing for your redemption, for my redemption. I want us to consider, as I wrap up this passage, I'll read from Psalm chapter 38. I'll begin the reading from verse 6. Like I said, this eve of Christmas dawn, as we commemorate the birth of Christ, you may actually go back and look back and said, have Christ redeemed me? To redeem means to buy back. Yeah. To redeem means to recover. All that the enemy has taken from us, the Lord can help us recover all. Yes. And let's see how the psalmist prayed his prayer. I believe he would have prayed in a reflection. As I read from Psalm 138, verse 6 to 8. Though the Lord be high, yet had he respect unto the lowly. It calls us to humble ourselves and reflect. But the proud, he knoweth from afar. I pray that wouldn't be your portion. That wouldn't be my portion. 7. Though I walk in the midst of trouble, thou wilt revive me. Thou shalt stretch forth thy hand against the wrath of my enemies, and thy right hand shall save me. The Lord will perfect that which concerns me. Amen. Thy mercy, O Lord, endureth forever. Amen. Forsake not the work of thy hand. Amen. That can be your Christmas. That can be your reflection tonight. As you go home, and perhaps stay in a quiet corner, that silent night, that holy night, the heavens can rejoice for your sake. I think that's the next song from the choir. God bless you. Have a Merry Christmas.
take our sin away. For everywhere it was a holy night. Oh, holy night.
Holy night.
It was a holy night.
Holy night. It was a holy night.
It was a holy night.
Holy night.
Holy night.
Holy,
holy night.
Holy night. It was a holy night. Oh, holy night.
It was a holy night.
Holy night.
Oh, holy night.
It was a holy night.
In appreciation to this wonderful concert that our young people have given to all of us. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Merry Christmas, and thank you very much for coming to enjoy this special night with our young people. I'm a young man too. I mention this from time to time. I don't consider myself as an old man. I may not be able to sing the way they sing as a result of what has happened to my voice as I've been adding 1 year to another year and to another year. But that was a beautiful presentation. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
May the Lord bless our young people.
Amen.
But permit me to say a few words about the youth ministry, and especially these choir members. It is very difficult many times to convey to them, I want to appreciate how much we appreciate them, how much we love them, how much we even pray for them. But we know that as time passes by, they will understand that we really appreciate our young people. We love them. They are a group of quality young people. And each time I say that, I mean that from the bottom of my heart. And I'm not the only one. I'm saying this on behalf of the ministry. So we want to ask you to please remember them in your prayers. The youth ministry is a vibrant ministry in our church, in terms of what the Lord is helping them to do, and more especially as we see things that are happening in the life of many young people. For us, by the special grace of God, we still have quite an army of young people that are still interested in the things of the Lord, and they are committed to doing it. Most of them are in the universities. Some of them are always with us. We love to see them from time to time. Their activities include end of the month activities that they put together, Youth Club for Christ, then the youth camp, and of course, the VOH. I know what it means, but maybe I ask one of them to say, what is VOH? Because anybody can give that any name. Can, now. All of them know. And? Verses of honor. They are, by God's grace. Yeah. And we like them, and we love them, and we pray that the Lord will bless them. For these to be a success, and actually we have quite a large number of young people here in London. We have them in all our branches, but the large part is concentrated here in London. We actually have someone behind the success of all that has been going on. And as I was thinking about this, it occurred to me that the youth ministry in this church, we had the first youth leader by the name, maybe some of you don't know, Isaac Shodipi was the first youth leader. Can you imagine that? He was, and he did a good job at it. When he passed on the baton, he passed that on to me. I was once a youth leader. And then later on, I passed that baton to Alban, whom some of you will know, who has returned to Nigeria now. And then Alban passed it on to Ola, who is the current pastor of this branch. And then Ola passed it to the first lady. The first lady youth leader. Well, this first lady youth leader, the Lord has helped us so much. I actually have a pet name for her. It has to do with what she does and how she represents the young people and the way she carries the young people. And as I was watching tonight, I was so encouraged, and I was so happy, even without saying anything to these young people in terms of what they should know, what they should do for their youth leader, the fact that they appreciate and they know how much effort she's putting into what she's doing, I think that is very encouraging. I think it's just like their heart and my heart, representing the ministry, our hearts are just beating together as one in terms of what they have done for her tonight. I called her Mother Hen. She just likes to protect and gather around and look after, and that's what she does. May the Lord bless Sister Ola. She's doing a very good job at that. You may not know too that she's even one of the choir leaders of this branch. You can see all that she's putting together for this hard work. And as a result, on behalf of the ministry, I will call Stella Adigan to come forward. And perhaps before Stella steps here, I want Sister Frances Olos Renoir to come forward first. Bottom of her heart, may the Lord bless you. Then we have Stella coming forward on behalf of the church. Thank you. I never knew what the young people were planning. I didn't say anything to them, so I, don't shake it too much. That's just a token.
Thank you.
I really appreciate you. Thank you so much. God bless you. We still have our young people that perhaps are not on this platform, and many of them present here tonight, many of them perhaps watching us right now. They are all part of this group. Even if all of them will join to sing, you will see that we have a very small platform anyway. So we appreciate them too. The same Lord who we've been praying to look after these ones will look after them as well.
Amen.
By God's grace. So at the end of this program, I want to encourage you, even if just for a few minutes, to please take time to pray. Just kneel down, say a few words to the Lord, and we know that the Lord will surely answer your prayers. And we would like to bring the Youth Choir and Orchestra Christmas concert to a close by singing the last congregational song that we have on the program, the First Noel, at the end of which the youth leader, Olos, will come forward to give us the closing prayer. We are going to stand up to sing the three verses of this song, the First Noel. Shall we stand up, please?
Father, we bless your holy name. We glorify you for this wonderful time, for this season, for this time that we remember your birth. Christ, you are the reason for this season. Lord, we bless you. We glorify you that you came as a babe for our redemption. Lord, we give you all the glory, the honor. Lord, the message of tonight, we pray that you will speak to all our hearts. Amen. Give us that joy, that peace that you came to give this world. Deliver us all from darkness. Amen. Shed your light in our lives. Amen. Bless us as we go home. Disperse us with your grace. Be with us. Bless us all tonight. Grant us a safe journey home. For in Jesus' name we pray.
Remember, let's take a few minutes to pray before we go. God bless you all.